I figured you'd be sick of drills by now. Hopefully our training exercises will be more interesting than what they've had you doing at the academy. The key on the desk opens encryption-based nanotech locks. When you pick it up, it will automatically be added to your key ring. Use the key ring to unlock the door and proceed to the next area. You're going to get a lot of equipment during these exercises. Press F1 at any time to access the inventory screen, which will let you add and remove items from the tool belt. Press F2 to view your current goals and any notes you may decide to take. On a typical mission, a UNATCO agent's objectives are logged electronically so that he can stay on task at all times. Now pick up a weapon and try to break open those crates. One of them's indestructible, but the others contain things you might find useful. Now pick up the lockpick and use it to open the door. Lockpicking takes time and expends the self-assembling resources of modern lockpicks. Just be patient and remember your training. At higher skill levels, you won't need as much time or lockpick resources to pick a lock. The code to the door has been stored in that data cube. Right-click on the data cube to read the contents, then type the code into the keypad. Activate the keypad with the right mouse button, just like you activate a data cube or any object in the world. Use the disposable multi-tools on the table to hack the keypad up ahead. The multi-tools resources are finite. When a tool is depleted, it becomes useless. The manual describes other uses for the multi-tool. At higher skill levels, you'll need less time and multi-tool resources to hack a given device.
Welcome to the combat training area. I am Günther Hermann, and I will be monitoring your progress here. We will start with weapon familiarization. Your first exercise will be to learn a little about aiming and targeting. Step up to the shooting range to the west. The targets are released by using the buttons on the counter. Release the first target and take a few shots with one of the pistols until it is destroyed. Notice the targeting reticle appears when you aim at a target. Good. If you hold your aim for a few seconds before firing, you will notice the reticle starts out wide and tightens as you hold. The longer you aim as a target without moving, the greater your accuracy will become. Release the second target and aim before shooting this time. Good work. Now proceed to the next area.
I'm here to pick up all munitions and equipment. Thanks for the cooperation, Agent.
This is a rifle range. Here, you will learn one of the ways skill level makes a difference in your accuracy. Step up to the shooting range. The targets are released using the buttons on the counter. Release the first target and destroy it with the rifle. Use the rifle scope by pressing the left bracket key to turn the scope on. Excellent. Now we are going to raise your skill with rifles to master level. Release the second target and destroy it. Good work. As you can see, higher skills give you better range, accuracy, and effectiveness. Proceed to the next area when you are ready.
Hand in your equipment. That's right. No cheating.
The demolitions training area. First, you will learn to use the LAM as a proximity mine. Approach the bay window and you will see a LAM placed on the target board on the black and red wall. Press the first button next to the window and a security bot will be released. Watch as he nears the LAM. LAMs placed on the walls are proximity triggered. horn lamp. Take a lamp from the munitions bay and proceed to the red and black wall below. Get as close to the wall as possible when you place the lamp. If you aren't close enough, the lamp will fall to the ground and detonate. Proceed to the next area for more demolitions training.
You'll need a few extra lamps for the demolitions area. Here, catch.
Next, you will need to breach the doors in the hallway. Throw a lamp down to the end of the hall. Once it blows, proceed down the corridor. Notice how the wooden door was destroyed and the metal and barred doors remained. Remember this for future reference. Beyond the destroyed door, you can see a damaged piece of wall you can also breach with a lamp. Try that now. Excellent. Notice that the wall is opened. Look for other weakened walls, such as this, and your lamp and other explosives will allow you to breach them. Continue through that breach and on to the next section. Beyond the door is the grenade defusing facility. Here you will learn how to remove planted explosive devices. At each of the corners of this area, you will find a lamp planted on the wall. You must disarm and remove all four lamps before you can proceed to the next section of training. You will need to move up to the lamp quickly and defuse it by right-clicking. A second right-click will remove the lamp from the wall. Warning, Agent Denton. This simulated experience, real lamps will not be so forgiving. You may proceed to the next area.
Gotta start the next section without arms or tools. Rules are rules.
Remember the four basic tactics to avoid detection. Crouch behind concealment. Stay behind enemies. Move slowly to avoid making noise. And use shadows to conceal yourself. Be alert to every possibility. I hope you remember this lesson, Agent. They have assigned us to be partners, and I will not stop to hold your hand and repeat myself when we are facing a real enemy.
Now for the last test. You have to find a way across the river to the exit on the other side. There's more than one way to get there, depending on your approach and the skills you want to use. It's up to you. Make use of the IFF system to identify enemies. Crosshairs will highlight red over enemies, green over allies, and white over neutrals. Step up to each hologram.
Thank you.